Good morning, guys.
7:30.
Time to get the day started.
Ooh, mama be looking rough.
That's okay. Do you ever wake up feeling like really dehydrated? I do. And honey, I just chug a bottle of water. Like chug it, get it down. You feel better. You really do. I mean, that doesn't mean we're not going to have some coffee. I got it ready to go. Okay, got my other mug in the dishwasher. So, today is Monday. Today is December. Is it just the second? Sweet Lord. I mean, it feels like I've been doing Vlogmas for a few days now. I guess not. If you are ever blessed with the opportunity to work from home, get yourself in the habit of waking up and showering and putting on clothes. And I'm not someone who can like lay in bed all day. I don't like to waller. Does that make sense? I don't know. So even if I'm not working, I didn't work for 3 years before I took my job last year. Even if I wasn't working, I would wake up and at least put on like, you know, leggings or yoga pants and a t-shirt, you know, something like that. And just, it made me feel not so like bummy. I don't know. But if you ever are blessed with the opportunity to work from home, my recommendation is wake up, shower, and just put on something comfy, but put on clothes. You know, get out of your pajamas and you're a little bit more ready to take on the day. So after the weekend, it takes a little longer to sign on the system because like you have to do like your VPN and things like that. So it's only 7:30. My shift doesn't start until 8. But I like to go ahead and like sign on and get all that going just to make sure I don't have any like connectivity issues, things like that, and get my VPN going and all that jazz. So I'm going to go ahead and go sign on, and then I'm going to go and take a shower and get me on. Just usually, like, you know, here in December, I'll just put on like leggings and a hoodie and no makeup, nothing like that. I'm not fixing up, you know, but just being prepared to take on the day and be getting in a mindset of this is work, you know, and just being up and at them and ready to go. I highly recommend you do that if you ever do take a position working from home. I mean, I'm sure there's lots of folks that don't. You could work in your pajamas, but I'm just not that kind of person. And it makes me feel ready to go if I'm kind of showered and woke up a little bit. So I'm going to go sign on, going to shower, and then I'll check in with you. I'm going to wait to make my coffee until after my shower. So I'll see you all in a little bit. So it is 5 till 8. I'm getting ready to sign on. Well, I'm already signed on. Getting ready to get on my computer. Got me some coffee. Got a shower. Got clean clothes on. No makeup, but that's how I roll. Good morning, Oliver.
Good morning, Oliver.
Are you snoozing by the tree? So, typical work uniform. These leggings are by Yogalicious from Amazon. They are fabulous. Fit Kicks. I showed these yesterday in my vlog. I love these. They are house shoes / shoes. You can wear them out. And just a hoodie. So I'm pretty sure this one came from Target many, many moons ago. Is Mossimo even a brand still? I think that's what this is. I don't know. All right, gonna go work. So do you guys ever click list? These are the items I've got going on here. When placed my order. It's the best thing in the world, Walmart. Mid-morning break. It is 10 till 10 and I have came downstairs to make me a cup of coffee. Second round. Been in meetings all morning. Merry Christmas. So I'm gonna run back upstairs. I just come downstairs to make the coffee and then back up I go. So I'll check in a little while. Hey guys, so it is lunchtime. Show you what I'm fixing here. I showed this the other day in my video. I love cabbage with kielbasa. You just fry your cabbage and
fry up your kielbasa a little bit. And it's so good, especially if you're doing like low carb or keto. Throw in some butter. Like, I like more cabbage than meat. I'm a veggie girl. So, just gonna pop some of this in the microwave. I am quite hungry because I have not, you know, had anything to actually eat since, you know, all I've had is coffee. So, I've already washed these berries. I'm gonna take some blackberries. Just a few. Got these yesterday at Sam's Club. And then a couple pieces of, this is Kobe Jack, I think. It's either Kobe Jack or Monterey Jack. I think it's Kobe Jack. Yeah, should be Kobe Jack. Just a couple pieces of cheese. So, that is what lunch is looking like. I'm a hungry girl. So, I'm going to eat. I'm going to take my food back upstairs and just work while I eat. And I'll check in a little while. Typical work day. So, see y'all. Okay, guys. So, I just got home from getting my groceries. And I'm going to pop some of these in the crock pot. These are just, yes, meatballs. I just got the Great Value brand. I've never had these before. Johnsonville had my favorite meatballs, like at Meijer, and they disappeared. Like, they stopped carrying them. I don't know if they just quit making them or what, but it is what it is. I'm going to use the rest of this marinara. Let me put some water in here. Rao's marinara is not only the best as far as flavor goes, to me, in my opinion. And it's not marketed as low carb, but it is. So, in one serving, which is half a cup is a pretty good amount of sauce. There are 4 carbs. Like, that's not bad at all. So, in this whole jar, there's only 20. Can't beat that with a stick. So, I'm just gonna pour in. These are already cooked. This is mainly just to heat them up. I'm gonna do about half the bag. On the top, I have another jar. It looks different. Okay. So, just gonna pop the lid on. I've got that on high. I just want them to get good and bubbly. I can put mozzarella on them later. So, just wanted to have something else cooked up for the week. Got some chicken thawing that I had in the freezer. So, yeah. I am, in fact, still working, so I'm gonna go and finish that up, and then I will meet you back here in a little while. Hey guys, so it is about 5 o'clock. I'm done with work for the day, thank God. I did go pick up my groceries, and I just wanted to mention these. Have y'all ever ate them? They are a protein bar. They're by Power Crunch. This one is in peanut butter cream, and it is very good. It would remind you of the Little Debbie. Is it Little Debbie or Lil? Maybe I'm getting her confused with Lil Wayne and stuff. I don't know. Whichever it is. You know the Nutty? Is it Nutty Bars? Nutter, but I don't know. Whatever it is. Those little brown, like the milk chocolate ones that are more like square and kind of rectangle, I guess. This tastes remarkably like that. So in one, they call it cookie, one bar, there are 10 carbs, 1 gram of fiber, so 9 carbs in this thing, and there are 13 grams of protein. 5 grams of sugar is all. They really are good. That's a little high for carbs, but the thing is, in the grand scheme of things, if you're going to eat a low-carb lifestyle, this is kind of the way I see things. I mean, honestly, I need to lose quite a bit more weight, so I might not be the best person to ask. But if this is a lifestyle change, this is how you're going to eat forever, you need like a candy bar, you know, or something sweet. And 9 carbs, like 9 net carbs, that's not terrible, you know, and you don't need to have one like maybe every day, you know, I mean, maybe. But you know what I'm saying? Like, you have to allow yourself indulgences. If you don't have food you love and you're really satiated, you're not going to stick with it. That's the way I see it. So,
I feel like my rear has been glued to the seat today, just getting my work done and stuff like that. So I'm kind of thinking, I've not been working out a whole lot lately. Well, none. So I subscribed to Beachbody. Have y'all ever done this? And then you download an app on your phone. Beachbody is the company that makes like all these exercise programs. You see them on TV. There's the Country Line Dancing one. What's it called? Country Up or I don't know, something like that. I'll put it here, whatever it's called. You see it every now and then. But like P90X, Insanity, all the different workouts that are online, those are by Beachbody, most of them. I mean, I'm sure there's some on there that's not, but Beachbody is huge. There's tons and tons of workouts. So you can pay like $39, I think is the fee, for 3 months. And I did a 3 month thing just to see, like, is it something I'm going to do? It's not been. I mean, I did for a while when I first signed up, but then I've not done it. What is that, Country Up or Cowboy Way or I don't know. It's something like that. It's really fun, like really fun. And you don't have to be in great shape. The dance moves are not hard. Your girl is a country line dancer. So David just got back from Portland on Friday night, really late, early Saturday morning. And if you remember, if you were with me last year, I had went to Portland with him as well. That is where his baby brother lives. And I had to work this week. So I wasn't able to go this year. But when we were there, and you have to know, I'm the only Caucasian in the room, which is fine. I mean, I don't give a hoot. And I'm the only redneck in the room, okay? They are legit. I'm not lying. His baby brother is a gastroenterologist. He's one of the nation's leading like specialists on hepatitis C and things like that. Brilliant people. His wife is a radiologist. His middle brother is a nephrologist, a kidney specialist. Like, they're very, very smart people. David's dad was a physician. His mom was a pharmacist, you know, things like that. So classy people, smart people, successful people. We were all in there and we were like, wow, well, you know, what y'all want to do? And I was like, I could teach y'all country line dancing. And they loved it. It was so fun. And I told David when he came home, I said, I bet they were missing my country line dancing, wouldn't they? Yes. You girls got a mean tush push. That's all I'm going to say. Just put that out there. But anyways, these dance moves are very easy. It's not as hard as a country line dance. So the way she does it, like she come, like they do two moves at a time. So she'll teach you two moves, you do them together, and then you get two new moves, and you just keep going over. So the most you have to remember are two moves. That's it. It's really fun. It goes by fast. You don't have to be in great shape. And it's not like P90X, you know, or Insanity, where you kind of have to be in shape in order to do those programs. You know what I mean? At least to some degree. This one is like very easy. It's fun. I love the music. It's just really good country music. What your girl likes. So I really need to do my homework because this is real life. I don't wear makeup every day. My friend is going to come over here tomorrow and I'm going to cook a shepherd's pie. I will show you that recipe. I don't think I've ever made this one. The only one I've ever made in Us Weekly or People Magazine one, I don't know, maybe 15, 20 years ago, the nanny for Prince Harry and Prince William, she shared her shepherd's pie recipe, and I made that one. It's in my cookbook still. But I ran across a recipe this week on something, I don't even know, recipes.com or whatever it is. I'll share it. But it looked good. So I thought, I'm going to go ahead and try that. And if you don't know what shepherd's pie is, I think it is a British type meal. But it's basically ground beef with some seasonings and vegetables in a pie pan. There is no crust. And then the topping is mashed potatoes. So no pie crust, but it's called shepherd's pie. So I'm going to make that for him tomorrow. He's been going through a bit of skin cancer. He's one of my best friends in this whole world. And he is facing another surgery. They could not remove it all. So I'm going to make him dinner and take care of him a little bit. And yeah, so tomorrow being Tuesday, my assignments are due on Wednesday. If I'm going to be busy kind of tomorrow, I need to go ahead and try to do that homework tonight. I want to. So just to get myself up and moving and not feel so sedentary, like if I had a fitness tracker, I would be lucky if I have taken 500 steps today. True. So that's it. One of the only bad things about working from home too, you do tend to be very sedentary. So I might turn that on. I don't think I'm going to let y'all watch me dance. You know, I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. But I'm going to eat my little bar. Have y'all seen where you can, they're hiring somebody to watch Hallmark Christmas movies. Have you seen that online? And you have to watch 24 Hallmark Christmas movies in 12 days. Totally doable, okay? For me. I mean, I'll watch them anyway, okay? So I'm thinking about applying. You have to apply by December 6th. Which is Friday. But I'm thinking, like, I think I might be able to win this. You have to love Christmas. If y'all want to apply, go ahead and apply. We'll all apply. It doesn't matter. Best person, get the job, honey. But all you have to do is love Christmas and post. You have to send them a video, what's like 2 minutes or less, of why you should be chosen. They send you popcorn and things like that, and you have to post on social media. I don't know. I'm sure the, you know, details of that would be released to you if you were chosen. But you get paid $1,000 to watch 24 movies and post about them and review them, review the movies online. I think I could win it. Between the Christmas cookie exchange, you know, my cookie making that I do, that I won here in my neighborhood, my decorations, my 6 Christmas trees, all my pajamas and outfits and parties, and I think I could win it. You know, DIY stuff, making my ornaments. I think I could win it. What y'all think? Should I apply? If I do, I'm going to shoot that video tomorrow. I'm going to think about it tonight. I had thought about doing it like maybe last week, and I just never took the time. I do have a busy schedule these days, so I don't know, but we'll see. I'm gonna go ahead and go turn on my country line dancing, and I'll be back. You all have not got to see a little baby much. Oh, Piper, she was still asleep this morning whenever I checked in with you guys. I leave her in the bed, and she's a lady of leisure. She sleeps in every day. I'm showing them your fancy bow tie for Christmas. You look so regal. And two, I've not even made my Christmas cards this year. So I'm thinking about just not doing that. That's another thing I could show. My Christmas cards that I've made. But if y'all remember my really cute picture that I made last year for a Christmas card. I love that one. It's one of my favorite ones. But I had thought about doing a card of Piper. She was Bullseye, the Target doggy, for Halloween. And I thought for Christmas, she could be Snoopy. Did y'all watch Charlie Brown Christmas? Like, the Red Baron? I think that's the Christmas episode. I don't know. Where Snoopy is the fighter pilot on his doghouse. He loves to do that anyway. But I think it's the Red Baron at Christmas. I don't know. But I made Piper Snoopy. I bought her a pair of goggles and made her a green cap. So I'll show you. I'll put in a picture here. I don't know that I'm going to make them, you know, or use it as my Christmas. I don't know that I have enough time to even fool with it now because it's already December. And I would have to order the cards, all that stuff. So we'll see. I don't know. But she just wanted to tell you guys hi. She's so sweet. All right. I'm going to turn on the country music. The line dancing and work out for a little bit, and I'll be back.
Workout is complete. Your girl is sweaty. I have a little doggy over here, yes. And we're going to sit here. I've got my meatballs, and she has a little bowl of food. And we're going to eat our dinner. We're going to dine together this evening, and I'm going to do my homework. I have several assignments due this week, so I'm going to do my homework, and then I'll be back. I'm going to show you how I do my hair oil that I sleep in at least once a week. And I have such bad roots. And considering this past weekend was just 2 weeks. And 2 weeks for my hair to grow this month. That's quite a bit. So I think the oils really do play a big role in that. I will show you that here in just a few minutes. But for the next probably 2 hours, I'm going to be doing homework. So it's 6. Hopefully around 8 I can wrap this up. If not earlier. And then I'll show you how I get ready for bed. And then I need to try to edit and upload. We'll see. So I'll see you all in the
morning. Okay, guys. I just let my hair down from my clip because I had been working out and I pulled my hair up. I think between the bio seal, and if you don't know what I'm referring to, I take a collagen stimulator replacement, okay? Not only do I drink the collagen of the morning, that is the Bobbi Brown from the cosmetics Bobbi Brown. Her brand is called Evolution 18. You get it at Walmart. My hair be looking bad. Not only do I drink that, but I take BioSeal. You get that from Amazon. And that stimulates the cells in your body that produce collagen to kind of like wake back up and form collagen again. Because once you hit about 20 years of age, you stop producing collagen like you once did. So I'm going to show you my oil routine. I try to do this at least one day a week. As you can see, my hair is down to here. Okay. And March 25th, I started my job. My new job, and my hair swung on top of my shoulders. So it's grown that much since March. It's pretty good. So, you know, the thing is not only do you need to have growth from here down, you know, like growth from the scalp, but you need to maintain the length and keep it from breaking. Because if you're growing from the root and you're breaking, it's still not going anywhere. So here's what I do. I have a bunch of oils here that I use. These two I got from Amazon. I'll start with those. With essential oils, you need a carrier oil. So my carrier oil, that just means an oil that makes it safe to be on your skin, like a transporter, I guess. So I use some argan oil and I use rosemary. There's certain oils that really stimulate hair growth at your scalp, and rosemary is one of them. I've watched so many videos. I just get a glob of argan, a glob of rosemary, peppermint oil. This is another like powerhouse in terms of scalp health, hair growth, and I just shake these on, and here is lavender. Just a lot. Jamaican black castor oil. Okay? And just add a good amount to that. I just start rubbing it in on my scalp. And then I rub my hands together again, get it back on my fingertips, and you really just want to work it in your scalp. Take your time and just kind of rub it in on your scalp. You can do the inversion method where you dip your head over. Whatever you want to do. Okay? Alright. Worked all that in. Look how good that looks. Yes. And then for the length of my hair, I just do coconut oil. Oh. This particular one, I got at Walmart. It's very hard. Like, very hard. So, you have to work it a little bit to get it to melt. But I don't heat it up anymore. I just take some in my hand. And when you rub it through your hands, it will melt. That sounds a little gross. Okay, and I just start rubbing it through. And I really saturate my hair. I take one of these guys. And that is what I, you know, just one of those little soft hair ties. And I get a comb. And I bend my head over and I brush my hair smooth. It really and truly doesn't even look that bad. I mean, just... And it smells divine. Like, I love the peppermint oil. I think it smells really good. And I just keep my oils, I'll show you, in this little container my friend gave me. I look hideous tonight, I'm sorry. I will wear makeup tomorrow. But I just put them all in this. So they're all in there. And this is one of those scalp massagers. Have you seen those? They feel really good, and I do feel like it probably wakens up your scalp, but it's almost like it's too good. Like, when you do it to your head, it's like chills down your spine. Truly. They feel really good. They're cheap. $5 on Amazon. But I do feel like they do kind of awaken your scalp, if you can take the overstimulation. I'm going to go turn my camera off for the night, take my memory card upstairs, and... let the footage start uploading into my computer and then into iMovie. If I have time, I will edit tonight. But if not, then I'll just try to edit tomorrow. And yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching. And hopefully you got kind of a good idea of how my day goes being a nurse, working as a case manager, working from home. You know, the trick to it really is just staying focused, getting yourself in a mindset of, today we're working, and then just knocking those tasks off, right? So hopefully that gave you some ideas of how my day typically goes working from home. But yeah, I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. We are off to a really good start with Vlogmas. I'm kind of staying on track, trying to stay focused. I think having so much on my plate kind of forces me to be a little bit more productive. So guys, see you tomorrow. Good night.